महमूद वॉज वेरी सैड बिकॉज ही थॉट दैट इन ओल्ड डेज एवरीबडी न्यू अबाउट महमूद बट इन दीज डेज नो बडी न्यू अबाउट महमूद ऑल पीपल वर बिजी इन देयर वर्क एंड नो बडी took tension and nobody bothered about that who was living in their neighborhood. When Mahmood was younger and had fallen sick, everyone in the neighborhood had come to ask after his health, but now when his days were drawing to a close, no one visited him. True, most of his old friends were dead and his sons had grown up. One was working in a local garage. The other had been in Pakistan at the time of partition and had not been able to rejoin his relatives. Now listen, students. Here Mahmood thought and said that when he was young and when at the young age, whenever he falls sick, all people of neighborhood came to ask about his health. But nowadays, when he became old, nobody wanted to know about his health. His friends were died. His one son worked in local garage and other went to Pakistan. So it was difficult to come India to meet his family. The children who had bought kites from him 10 years ago were now grown men, struggling for a living. They did not have time for the old man and his memories. Listen, student, Mahmood said that children who bought kite from him became grown men and still struggling for their career. They were busy in fulfillment of their daily routine needs. Here Mahmood wanted to say that some children in their childhood used to buy kite from Mahmood, but in present time they were grown men and they all were busy in earning money. They had grown up in a swiftly changing and competitive world and they looked at the old kite maker and the banyan tree with the same indifference. Here, Mahmood said that people were very harsh and emotionless towards banyan tree and Mahmood. Mahmood means a person who was old. In these days, nobody gathered under banyan tree, Mahmood said that children who bought kite from him became grown men and struggling for their career. They were busy in fulfillment of their daily routine needs. They found banyan tree and Mahmood same, means they did not have interest in banyan tree and Mahmood. Here Mahmood wanted to say that a man who became old and banyan tree, both are useless for young people. Means young people saw them useless. Both were taking for granted permanent fixtures that were of no concern to the raucous, sweating mass of humanity that surrounded them. No longer did people gather under the banyan tree to discuss their problems and their plans. Only in the summer months did a few seek shelter from the fierce sun. Here, Mahmood said that people were very harsh and emotionless towards banyan tree and Mahmood. In these days, nobody gathered under a banyan tree. Only in summers, travelers took shelter under the banyan tree. But there was the boy, his grandson. It was good that Mahmud's son worked close by, for it gladdened the old man's heart to watch the small boy at play in the winter sunshine, growing under his eyes like a young and well-nourished sapling, putting forth new leaves each day. There is a great affinity between trees and man. Mahmud said that only my grandson gave me pleasure, and he felt happy whenever he saw his little grandson who played in sunshine. He saw his grandson as a small plant who need nourishment and growing day by day, like new leaves come out in a small plant. There is similarity between plant and man. We grow at much the same pace if we are not hurt or starved or cut down in our youth. We are resplendent creatures, and in our declining years we stoop a little. We remember, we stretch our brittle limbs in the sun, and then with a sigh we shed our last leaves. Mahmud described that trees and men grow in same manner. Both grow rapidly if nobody hurt them, and become bright. When both became older, both became reliable and days of life. Trees shed their leaves and became only wood, and man also become worthless. Here Mahmud described and said that the growth rate of man and plant are same. If no one hurt plant and a child, both grow very fast and they became bright and beautiful creature. But in the days of their declining, means when trees became old and man also became old, they became very reliable and trustworthy person. But at the time of end of the life, most of the people see them as a worthless and useless creature or man. Mahmud was like the banyan, his hands gnarled and twisted like the roots of the ancient tree. Ali was like the young mimosa planted at the end of the courtyard. In 2 years, both he and the tree would acquire the strength and confidence of their early youth. In this story, Mahmud, just like a banyan tree who became old with lots of experience and had lots of experience in his life, and roots of banyan trees also penetrate in the earth. Ali, who was the grandson of Mahmud, like a mimosa, a sensitive plant which Mahmud planted in the courtyard. Now Mahmud again said that the mimosa plant and the grandson Ali both were in growing stage. In the growing stage, both had confidence and power of youth stage. See students, the voice in the street grew fainter, and the Mahmud wondered if he was going to fall asleep. and dream as he so often did of a kite so beautiful and powerful that it would resemble the great white bird of the Hindus, Garuda, God Vishnu's famous steed. He would like to make a wonderful new kite for little Ali. He had nothing else to leave the boy. Now voices of street became low. It means he fall asleep and seeing a dream which he often dreamed that he made a very beautiful and powerful kite which looked like white bird like Varun which was carried by Hindu's lord Vishnu. Varun, all of you know, it's a Vahan of a god Vishnu. Vahan means like a rat is a Vahan of Lord Ganesha and peacock is a Vahan of Lord Kartik and lion is a Vahan of Ma Durga. Vahan means jis par wo sawari karte the, usko hum Hindi mein Vahan bolte hain. To yahan pe Mahmood hamesha ek dream dekhta tha jisme wo sochta tha कि वो इस तरीके की ब्यूटीफुल काइट बनाएगा जो कैसी दिखती है, दैट लुक्ड लाइक्ड स्टीड ऑफ गरुड़ा अ वाइट वर्ड. ही वांटेड टू मेक अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल काइट फॉर अली. सी स्टूडेंट, ही हर्ड्स अलीज वॉइस इन द डिस्टेंस बट डिड नॉट रियलाइज दैट द बॉय वॉज कॉलिंग हिम. द वॉइस सीम्ड टू कम फ्रॉम वेरी फार अवे. अली वॉज एट द कोर्टयार्ड डोर आस्किंग इफ हिज मदर हैड एज येट रिटर्न फ्रॉम द बाजार. When Mahmood did not answer, the boy came forward, repeating his question. The sunlight was slanting across the old man's head and a small white butterfly rested on his flowing beard. Mahmood was silent and when Ali put his small brown hand on the old man's shoulder, he met with no response. The boy heard a faint sound like the rubbing of marbles in his pocket. Now listen, student. He heard Ali's voice. It seems that Ali calling from distance. Ali was asking about his mother, but Ali did not get the answer from Mahmood. So he came to nearer by Mahmood. He repeated his question, but he saw that a white butterfly resting on the beard of Mahmood. Ali put his hat to Mahmood's shoulder, but he did not get the response. He heard the low sound of marble, which he kept in his pocket. He became afraid. Suddenly afraid, Ali turned and moved to the door and then ran down the street, shouting for his mother. The butterfly left the old man's beard and flew to the mimosa tree, and a sudden gust of wind caught the torn kite and lifted it in the air, carrying it far above the struggling city into the blind blue sky. Now Ali became afraid and ran towards the doors and went in the street, shouting for his mother. Now, see, the butterfly which was on the beard of Mahmood flew towards the mimosa tree which was planted by Mahmood. Now at that time one more thing also happened, that due to sudden blow of wind the kite which was caught and torn became free and flew high in the blue sky, far away from busy city and disappear in the sky. Now listen, student. Here writer wants to say that it's a imagination and personification. That writer said that Mahmood had died and now he was free from materialistic life, and he personified his life with struggling city and personified kite with Mahmud. Now listen, so here writers describes that like a kite, Mahmud also became free from the struggle of life, and now he could fly freely high in the sky just like a kite. I hope students, all of you have understood the chapter very well. Please students, read it again and try to find out the questions. It's very easy story. You just read it again. Thank you so much.